song. You'll then enjoy the ceremony, which will then take place, and please remain standing after the national anthem when you will be leaving to join your students outside, who will now be new graduates. Please switch off your mobile phones so they don't ring during the ceremony, thank you. And feel free to take photos during the ceremony, but please don't stand in the aisles to do so. We like to start on time, so ladies and gentlemen, please stand for your students.
Thank you. Thank you. te wharewānanga o tā maki makaurau, ko tēnei tā koutou rā pakahirahira, tā koutou pōtaitanga e, tēnā koutou, nau mai rā, pakatau mai rā.
Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoe fa, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council members and staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker, Mr. Bruce Plested. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland in convocation for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. Today, we will be conferring and awarding 3,185 qualifications on some 3,126 graduands in person and in absentia. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. Capping is a time for celebration. The graduation process today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland. And in this ceremony, you will experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well-deserved day of celebration. And of course, you are unique in graduating from the University of Auckland in the same month as His Excellency Ban Ki-moon, the Secretary General of the United Nations, on whom we bestowed an honorary Doctor of Laws degree at the beginning of September. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation, with one-third of the country's externally rated world-class researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked in the top 1% of the world's universities. We also have a strong commitment to Māori and Pacific education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. For Pacific students, the figure is over 40%. The quality and international reputation of a university are fundamentally driven by the achievements of the people, and our people have gained excellence again this year. For example, in May, our staff were successful in winning funding for 4 national centres of research excellence to be hosted or co-hosted by the University of Auckland. We're also partners in the other 2 centres that have been approved for funding, which means we will be contributing to all 6 of the national centres of research excellence. In July of this year, senior lecturer in law, Kylie Quince, was named as one of the 2014 winners of the National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Awards. Her award for sustained excellence in tertiary teaching means that for 12 of the last 13 years, at least one University of Auckland academic has received a national award of this kind. This is an outstanding tribute both to our accomplished staff and to the quality of teaching at this university. These achievements reflect the many achievements, not only of our academic staff, but also of the students who work with them and the many professional staff who support them. A key part of our challenge for the future, and one that is clearly reflected in our strategic plan, is to continue to invest in a community of highly accomplished staff and students. An important element of that investment is ensuring that our teaching and research facilities are of the highest quality. At our Newmarket campus, work is well underway on construction of the engineering research laboratories. These buildings represent an investment of more than $88 million to support our engineering research and postgraduate teaching for the benefit of all New Zealand. We've already occupied the first of the new facilities, and construction will be complete in February next year. Work has also begun on the new Science Tower on the corner of Wellesley and Simon Streets. This major construction project represents an investment of more than $300 million. It will allow us to upgrade science teaching and research and integrate the School of Psychology and the School of Environment into the main science precinct. This will in turn free up the Human Sciences Building for refurbishment as the centre of the arts faculty. Constant innovation is the cornerstone of a university such as ours. Innovative teaching and research is vital for long-term, sustainable economic growth of our country and social cohesion of our nation. This has never been more so than in the economic times we face in the wake of the global recession, Christchurch earthquakes, and the yet-to-be-defined effects of global warming. Universities equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined in an ever-changing world. So as you graduate today, please reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgraduate courses available to you at this university. Reflect on the changes in technology you've experienced in your lifetime, and remember that most of the technology that you will use in your working career has yet to be developed or commercialised. I ask you to do this because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow as you go out into the world, I urge you as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, in these hard times, I say we should be spending more on universities, not less. But don't worry, in the future we will be in touch with you, and when we do, please lend us your support. But that's enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day. The focus is firmly on your achievement. At the ceremony today, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. Please welcome Bruce Plested, who has an outstanding career as the founding director and Executive Chairman of Main Freight Limited. Prior to founding Main Freight, Bruce worked as an accountant with Fisher & Paykel, then moved with Don Rowlands to launch Champion Spark Plugs in 1966. Bruce began his career in the transport industry in 1970 with Container Freights, which later became the Bramble subsidiary New Zealand Freighters. He has now been involved in the freight forwarding business for over 40 years. Today, Main Freight is the largest domestic freight forwarder in New Zealand and is a global logistics provider, employing over 5,770 people in 230 branches throughout New Zealand, Australia, the Americas, Asia, and Europe. Bruce is a fervent conservationist and recycler. He has planted more than 100,000 native trees on his Waiheke Island property, and Main Freight as a company has been recycling waste products since 1988. Bruce is passionate about breaking the cycle of poverty in New Zealand and is a long-standing sponsor of the Books and Homes Project run by the Alan Duft Charitable Foundation. He says, "The only way that New Zealand will progress economically is through having a highly educated population with the highest expectations." I don't think anybody would disagree with that. Bruce is currently chairman of the Books and Homes Board of Trustees. In 2007, Main Freight also became a major sponsor of the Life Education Trust. Welcome, Bruce, and we look forward to hearing from you today.
Thank you. Chancellor, members of council, members of the university, and the latest graduates, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. To the Chancellor and the Executive, you must draw huge satisfaction to see this wonderful looking lot of young and not so young graduates with their families and friends. To the latest graduates, congratulations on gaining your degree. It takes a lot of diligence to get a degree. There are a number of you here tonight with 2 degrees. I hear of one who's got 4, and they were talking over 30 PhDs. Is that correct? It must have been said many times before, but where you are now is at the end of the beginning. I think it's important that you do not fear what lies ahead. Mostly working life is easier, less stressful than either school or university. You don't have to do homework. You don't have to sit exams and fail occasionally. You don't have to cram for exams. You don't have to keep drinking until dawn. You don't have to listen to lecturers that you don't like or disagree with, and you will have some of your own money to spend after you've repaid your loans. But what you do from now on gradually becomes critical as to where you make your mark in life. And it's only gradual. You can have several starts, and I advise you to have a number of starts if you're not in the position that you want to be in. Firstly, some people will already know what they want to do, to work teaching or in law or in engineering, and that's what I would advise that you do. You head off first to do. That's what I did. I left school, went to teachers' training college, and became a teacher. Secondly, I think you need to work on your fitness. Many students neglect their fitness through time discipline or neglect, or perhaps not realizing its importance. If you're going to make it in this world, You have to be physically fit continuously for long periods of your life. For my 70th birthday, a group of us from Main Freight walked up Mount Taranaki. Fitness and success are brothers. Thirdly, look inwardly at what you're good at. Do you get noticed? Are you an introvert? Are you an extrovert? Do you like order or do you like chaos? Do you like rules or like breaking them? Are you a team player or more of a loner? Try to understand where you are and what your skills best are. Often you will find that what you are good at, you also like. I gave up teaching age 19 and took up accounting at 22, finally qualified at 29. It totally changed my life. But I still didn't want to do accounting, but I could use the accounting so that I could understand business much more. And it gives me a huge advantage over other business people who can't really read a balance sheet. I can read a balance sheet upside down from 10 meters away. Fourthly, try to work out what you like. This can be hard if you like something but are not yet naturally good at it. Make the decision. You've got lots of time. Set out to find a way at getting good and preferably absolutely excellent at what you like as well as what you're good at. If you're good at what you like, it can be said, you can create a career from it, you can be said to never have to go to work. Fifth, set high standards in everything that you do. Life skills are so important. Things like getting up early, making your bed, learning to cook, doing your own cleaning, fixing things that are broken, caring and considering others, and perhaps most important, being positive at all times. The more positive you are, the further you get ahead in this world. And doing your job, whatever it is, with excellence. Somehow you have to combine this discipline with a bit of rule breaking. Some rule breaking is always necessary wherever you are, but with disciplined logic and emotion, your rule breaking will create success. Number six, be ever so grateful of the luck of your birth and the country in which you were born. Live by the maxim, would Mum approve of what I'm doing? I do it all the time. In 1987, we took over a company and they were the same size as we were, so we were doubling our size. And I went and saw my mother and said, should we publicise this or should we be quiet about it? We had unions watching us, we had the marketplace looking at us, and my mother said to me, well, darling, I've always thought you did so well because you kept your head down and didn't have everybody trying to knock it off all the time. We run our company like that. We try and keep our head down and not get our head knocked off. Wear rose-coloured glasses and see your surroundings and acquaintances in a positive perspective all the time. Most people are honest and trying to do what they at least think is their best. Communicate high expectations from everybody around you. It includes all those children who look as if they will never learn or come from destitute homes. Have high expectations from them. Seventh, this is an important one. People sometimes laugh when you bring this up, but try to recognize crossroads in your life. They will come through, and sometimes you just think, oh, well, that was a handicap or that was something. But if there's a global financial crisis, you have some sort of an accident, you get made redundant, you get fired, somebody close to you dies, is a crime committed somewhere that you have something to do with, or world events. Bad events are always fantastic opportunities for making you really think and take strong action. Do I want to be here? Do I want to die doing this? What if I never see the world? How are we going to benefit from this event? Main freight grows about 10% from every major crisis that there is, because we make a lot of tough decisions because of the crisis. Number eight, if you start to think, I like this, I think I'm good at it, I think I'm better than those already doing it, then have a go. Either apply for that bigger role or start up your own business and do it. Every single thing in our lives is a result of someone having a go, inventing something or improving on it. From the clock that wakes you up, the bed you get out of, the carpet on the floor, the cereal you eat for breakfast, the traffic lights, the road, the bitumen, everything. That's how Main Freight started. I was fired in one of these crossroads, and I thought, what am I good at? And I said, well, I'm pretty good at freight. And I thought, well, actually, I think I'm really good at freight. I thought, I'm going to have a go at doing this myself. And so we started the business with just $7,000. And today, as you heard the figures, we're in 20 countries around the world. We do have $2 billion of turnover. And it all came about through thinking, I'm good at this, I like this, I'm going to have a go at it. And please, you're not an entrepreneur just because you invent an app, but you're getting the right idea. Number nine, try to wipe the word I from your vocabulary. When you can get your sentences to start with we, have you considered, have you noticed, some people, would you suggest, always it's about what we are trying to achieve, not what I am trying to achieve. You will achieve a huge amount more if it's we going forward than I going forward. And number 10, the last recommendation is, start thinking about making a difference to your neighbourhood or community or country or the world at a young age. We can all make a difference. And the more of us who do seek to make a difference, the better the world will be. Be like the Boy Scouts. Seek to do a good turn for someone every day. Be courteous when driving. Smile at those who you meet every day. Understand part of your job on earth is to make those you come into contact with on any day feel a bit better than before they met you. Good luck. You're now totally in control of the rest of your life. Ka kite anō.
Thank you, Bruce, for a humorous yet inspirational speech. Can you all join with me in thanking Bruce once again for his address? This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University at which the Pro-Chancellor, Peter Kiley, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education, Professor Aitken, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Education. Graduate Diploma in Teaching, Early Childhood Education. Mayada Hassan Ali. Grace Devi Atmaji. Renee Therese Duda. Marie Hannon Ganaji. Gabrielle Cara Gomez. Selvi Ganda. Hamida Moez Giovanni. Reshna Sharma Lal. Yi Jin Lee. Elizabeth Ann McElwain. Maria Cindy Kapati Mikado. Andrea Rosa Moon Watson. Rashila Naidu. Jessica Rawlinson. Karen Bakashni Somal Sharan. Deborah Ann Sutherland. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Primary. Christopher Daniel Groen. Chia Hua Maggie Lee. Emma Victoria Livesey. Jonathan Paul Merritt. Linda May Barnum Porteous. Abdulmuati Abu Fatah Abdulmuati Ramadan. Angelica Lisa Richards. Joanna Jamie Siakimoto. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Secondary, Jessica Renee Cathro. Rebecca Elizabeth Fernley. Natalie K. McPherson. Kalepe Seuli Mafi. Candice Rose Stock. Isikili Tafia. Graduate Diploma in Teaching English in Schools to Speakers of Other Languages, Lillian Leofofu Amo. Jennifer Margaret Burt. Rasheed Khan. Latini Peato. Esba Shayad. Newtoa Tonomali. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching, Maureen Ann Anderson. Sarah Michelle Ashley. Si Hua Baik. Michelle Borta. Daniel John Cavett. Vanola Cook. Suzanne Alice Collette. Blanche Ann Curra Briggs. Hannah May Davy. Chantel Gabrielle Dijon. Taeri Catherine Myrie Fennec. Dominic Jesse Grant. Yvonne Estelle Grant. Umutai to Uiho Greg. Melissa Jane Hart. Kate Louise Henderson. Song Hee Hong. Elise Zara Hopkins. Pauline Marie Houston. Andrea Marie Howie. Athena Joyce Banabi Jacinto. Shelley Diane Johnson Lowe. Jimin Kim. Sarah Jane King. Melanie Diana Cluett. Pankudi Kumari. Alethea Abigail Lamott. Renee Brooke Lawson. Fa'afua Savalina Levasa Totolo. Jennifer Ann Legg. Rosita Levy. Brian Liu. Megan Elizabeth Lockwood. Uatita Luafalealo. Elizabeth Thalani Lamanongi Mahakita. Ofaki Kolisi Manavahetau. Nicole Ann Manuel. Hayley Marie McGregor. Anne Elizabeth Merton. Wanda Nalisitama Nalisitama. Tracy Jean Eileen Norton. Marie Christine O'Leary. Petraea Marie Patterson. Ueta Pene Ta'avau. Simone Demarith Poganpal. Nicola Margaret Pollard. Catherine Mary Preston. Te Rumoana Puna. Kirsten Janice Louise Ratu. Ragasmitha Raya Petty. Kelly Lee Simpson. Hazel Marie Smith. Eunice Ann Gilly Bibal Solomon. Alexandra Grace Stevenson. Nikki Nicole Paro Sterling Fongsa. Joshua James Taylor. Joseph George Tahaki. Rina Wehe Toby. Loi on Drake to Tongyavalu. Christo Bully Tuea. Penisimane Lolo Vete. Lisa Petter, Susie Wilson. To the degree of Bachelor of Education, teaching English to speakers of other languages, Nolati Far Hanum Abdul Hakim. Nurul Jajua Abdullah Azizi. Ayn Liyani Aynol Azmi. Amira Amir. Mihawani Anwar. Siti Amalini Nadia Ismail. Jesnor Ezrin Mart Jizat. Shifa Hushna Muhammad Azmi. Farah Adibar Roslan. Nirizati Zainon. To the degree of Bachelor of Human Services, Najma Alaverdi Gorji. Tony Kennedy Ikifitu. Litia Senior Milo. Miranda Judith Ashley Palmer. To the degree of Bachelor of Physical Education, Bryn Dorothy Armstrong. Ryan Grant Stefan Borthwick. Nathan J. Bridgeland. Mary Loretta Laetawa. Takura Ronga Ngata Arerengamate. Martin James Perry. Rebecca Kate Yee. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work, Te Arahi Potahi Tahuka August. Mary Fanalua Collins. Analia Makalita Evatamahuka. Solia Jackman. Wei Yan Wang. Postgraduate Diploma in Counselling Theory with Merit, Isabel Marion Dillon. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Distinction, Viviana Victoria Becker-Jara. Carolyn Rose Crow. Mahara Anake. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Merit, Karen Mary Bowie. Kokila Devi Gomez in Literacy Education. Juliet Reshmi Patab. Alethea Catherine Smith. Postgraduate Diploma in Education, Samuntra Devi Dutt. Justine Roimata Irena Kingi. Yeah! Gurdev Kaur Pritam Singh. Sumanjalan Vandana Lal Sharan. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership with Distinction, Robert Mark Ashcroft. Andrew Simon Brown. Sarah Jane Kemble. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership with Merit, Sharona Jawivant. David John Lowe. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership, Vanessa Mary Brambor. Betty O'Brien. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision with Distinction, Tanya Margaret Beekmans. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision with Merit, Laurel Ann Bobsing. Kim Nairi Crombie. Postgraduate Diploma in Social Work with Distinction, Emma Jane Weeks. Postgraduate Diploma in Social Work, Lopiseni Fungale. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with First Class Honours, Julian Marie Sagwinson Pimentel. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Katurina Arahanui Ropati. To the degree of Master of Counselling with First Class Honours, Wang Ting Chuang. Rebecca Amy Rylands. To the degree of Master of Counselling with Second Class Honours First Division, Rebecca Sadhana Dam. Michelle Ann Hay. Elizabeth Susan Hurlow. To the degree of Master of Education with First Class Honours, Martha Carolina Britz. Sandra Jean Lang Chandler. Tanya Ruby Cliff. Neil Jason Morrow. Justine Mary O'Hara Gregan. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours, First Division, Jocelyn Amelia Christians. Damien Roy Thompson. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Rachel Terry Barnett. Rachel Mary Hughes. To the degree of Master of Education, Perpetua Nomsa Marauda. To the degree of Master of Educational Leadership with First Class Honours, Kirk Vaughan Sargent, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership with Merit. Susan Joy Smith. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Kelly Francis Bigwood in Education. Simon John Denon in Education. Sheridan Lee Gall in Education. Julian Allen Powell in Education. Rajesh Ram in Education. Christian D. Swanick in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Jerodin Olavaigafa Fetua Yosefo in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies, Sonali Jane Carter in Education. Maria Teresa Pascaceres in Education. Patrick Coakley Winkleman in Education. To the degree of Master of Social Work with First Class Honours, Young Hee Han. To the degree of Master of Social Work with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Jing Hu. And in absentia, those other persons named in the official record qualify for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Education.
I now call upon the Deputy Dean of Engineering, Professor Hyland, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Deputy Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Engineering. Graduate Diploma in Engineering. Bhushan Shashikant Kohli. Bao Lin Li. Fahim Iqbal Mushrif. Menghan Wang. Yuan Yong. Chen Zhu. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering. Shuvik Biswas. Stephen Chung. Rhys Alavaran Gargason. Alisi Violetti Arcia. G. Wynne Desmond Ho. Uderoa Manu Stewart Kainamu Wheeler. David Andrew Leslie. Jade Rose Littleton. Jung Mao. Michael Yong Ra. Lavinia Raj. Nishit Shah. Mo Hong Tso. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honors with First Class Honors. Sakar Avakovich Bastajan in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Michael David Basto in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Monica Bowman in Mechanical Engineering. Yen Lin Fong in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Nicholas Raymond Just in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Corey Leonard Koch in Engineering Science. Samuel Allen Joseph McArdle in Computer Systems Engineering. Zach Henry McMaster in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Samuel Mark Highland Metzen in Software Engineering. Mary Pauline Grace Orden Santos in Software Engineering. Sheldon C. Nok So in Software Engineering. Benjamin Yen in Mechatronics Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honors with Second Class Honors, First Division. Karen Anand in Mechanical Engineering. Otari Beldyshevsky Shodatsi in Mechatronics Engineering. Emma Teitumanako Brown in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Josiah Campbell in Civil Engineering. Min Chun in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Eric Shu Wei Gu in Software Engineering. Thomas William Haywood in Engineering Science. Leslie He in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Mark Christopher Jameson in Mechanical Engineering. Lan Jiang in Civil Engineering. Hyun Jai Ju in Mechatronics Engineering. Christopher Michael Lam in Computer Systems Engineering. Kai Young Lee in Mechanical Engineering. Yan Liu in Computer Systems Engineering. Christine Catherine Tan Livesage in Mechatronics Engineering. Nurul Husna Bentney Othman in Chemical Materials Engineering. Ian Gregory Patterson in Computer Systems Engineering. Stephen Charles Payne in Chemical Materials Engineering. Philip Petreski in Civil Engineering. John Hein Fluke in Civil Engineering. Brent Franciscus Riley in Mechatronics Engineering. Ayushi Sharma in Mechanical Engineering. Hitart Umesh Sharma in Software Engineering. Esther Jean Smith in Civil Engineering. Nathan Ernest Smith in Civil Engineering. James Craig Upton in Civil Engineering. Xiao Ri Wong in Civil Engineering. Haley Emma Brothers Ware in Mechanical Engineering. Benjamin Yoni Willits in Mechanical Engineering. Stanley Leung Sia in Software Engineering. Jeremy Owen Young in Mechanical Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Intan Sharini Benti Abdul Reni in Chemical Materials Engineering. Sophia Waisan Chan in Mechanical Engineering. Young Bom Cho in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Chiuk Phi Vincent Chow in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Karsten Ma On Wong Kuratsa in Biomedical Engineering. Luke Gerald Dickinson in Civil Engineering. Upachi Bo Chung Huang in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Anuradha Lakmali Ilaprima in Civil Engineering. Anas Amaril Hakim bin Jamal Nasir in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Malat Sudara Kurunaratna in Software Engineering. Joshua Simon Masilamani in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Neil Moraes in Engineering Science. Rebecca Marie Phelps in Civil Engineering.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Hanny Lee will now perform Introduction a Rondo Capriccioso, Opus 28, by Camille Sasson.
Thank you.
Thank you for that brilliant performance. Will you please join with me in showing your appreciation again? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Engineering and Faculty of Law, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, Professor Nick Smith, to present further graduands in that faculty.
Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting you the further students qualified for the award of diploma or conferment of degree in the Faculty of Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Mason Jesse Popita in Civil Engineering. Xiaowang Quinn in Engineering Science. Faiz Dean Salam in Civil Engineering. Samuel Philip Tuppen in Computer Systems Engineering. Michael John Ware in Mechanical Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering, Honours Conjoint with First Class Honours, Jason Kunhu Chang in Civil Engineering and Bachelor of Laws. Matthew Richard Chain in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Yanyi Chu in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Laws. Charlotte Rosemary Elizabeth Judith Davis in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Arts. Benjamin John Hubbard in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Simonius Nicholas Ryan Yeager in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Laws. University Graduate Scholar Kevin Echin-J in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Arts. Hudson Ross Tooley in Electrical and Electronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours Conjoint with Second Class Honours First Division, Sing Tong Goa in Mechatronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Arts. Brabian Peter Osborne in Electrical and Electronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Karthik Subdur Pabhu in Mechatronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Edward Michael Roberts in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Master of Energy with First Class Honours, Nara Azam. To the degree of Master of Energy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Todd Owen Douglas. Kelly Valerie Takeda Moody. Alexandra Rivera Daz. Guan Chen Tay. Yulin Wang. Chrislyn Braganza in Engineering Science to the degree of Master of Engineering with First Class Honours. Jay Chow Chen in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Jonathan Chi Yu Chow in Software Engineering. Mark Richard Deacon in Mechanical Engineering. Bingzishi He in Mechanical Engineering. University Graduate Scholar James Randall Cusow in Mechanical Engineering. Mustafa Marabi in Software Engineering. Masha Marinajad in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Mashio Alejandro Munz Allegra in Civil Engineering. Ruchi Jainaradhan VS in Bioengineering. Jin Zhang in Mechanical Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering with Second Class Honours, First Division, Alan John Deacon in Mechanical Engineering. Siddharth Gautam in Mechanical Engineering. Xiaoxing Hu in Software Engineering. Vijay Adahatharan Mohan in Software Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Jiaqing Liu in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering Management with First Class Honours, Bradley James Burridge. To the degree of Master of Engineering Management with Second Class Honours, First Division, Salah Jehanguri. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies with First Class Honours, Bing Bing Dong in Construction Management. Unkor Kashikuma Gandhi. Kevin Kuhestani in Construction Management. Jianlong Li. Haomin Ma. Stuart Charles McDougall in Transportation. Sahul Momi Yang in Transportation. Andrew David Steele. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Komal Ali Abbas in Construction Management. Karen Kumar Ashok. Suriram Ali Vidarang Suguma Manan. Shara Bataria. Zergang Chen in Construction Management. Ernesto III, Makatal de Pertalta. Suji Gore. Srinivas K. Dikata in Construction Management. Gothami Malnaori Krishnara in Construction Management. Rajakrishnan V.G. Gutham in Medical Devices and Technologies. Mohan Kumar Sental Kumar. Najaya Vaz Hapuli Kujamon in Geotechnical Engineering. Yang Mo in Construction Management. Piwin Zhang. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Abdali Man Ateg A. Alogabi. Davy Feng Wei Cheng in Construction Management. Lohesh Gojin Annie. Singang Goa. Shashidhari Itaki Lakshminara Shimhara in Transportation. Rohit Chini Vas Kanajha. Syed Abdul Najib Purin. Victor Macassis Santiago in Transportation. Vidhail Tapari in Food Process Engineering. Rahul Verma. Ruben Gao. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies, Anup Kumar Chowdhury Bharat Singh Chowdhury. Parachi Vijay Gujar. Vignesh Sumaraman. Yeah. Wei Yang Wang. Chen Zhao. And in absentia, those persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Engineering.
I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Law, Dr. Stockley, to present graduands in that faculty.
Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Law. Graduate Diploma in Law, Muhammad Abdur Rahman. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws, Monica Ashley Davis. Jacqueline Francis Fa'imali Lafa Lafa Fa'amatu A'inu. Rhonda Kahu Fafita. Charlotte Jane Gubb. Terry Hoffman. Joanne Gaynor Kent Johnston. Amanda Ong. Marie Lillian Roberts. Nikolai Marco Santa Maria. Leah Renee Wijeratna. Peter Allen Wilson. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws Conjoint, Sarah R. Abdul Magid Abul Kaban and a Bachelor of Arts. Laura Patricia Berger and a Bachelor of Arts. Joseph Grant Bracewell and a Bachelor of Commerce. Samuel Matthew Brown and a Bachelor of Arts. Yujing Choi and a Bachelor of Arts. Alexandra Rose Cornwall and a Bachelor of Arts. Amber Louise Davis and a Bachelor of Science. Andrew Robert Christopher Draper and a Bachelor of Arts. John Kieran Gafer and a Bachelor of Commerce. Charlene Antoinette Going and a Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Louise Graham and a Bachelor of Arts. Courtney Jade Henley Smith and a Bachelor of Arts. Shivani Jadriram and a Bachelor of Arts. Talise Marie Kelly and a Bachelor of Commerce. Casey Lee and a Bachelor of Commerce. Christine Sue May Lee and a Bachelor of Arts. Jangmin Lim and a Bachelor of Commerce. Michelle Leo and a Bachelor of Commerce. Nathan Patrick Luscombe and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alana Rose Manson and a Bachelor of Arts. Hannah Ellis Martin and a Bachelor of Arts. Caitlin Elizabeth Merriman and a Bachelor of Arts. Roimata Aroha Afimati Gabrielle Mitchell and a Bachelor of Commerce. Selena Sangeeta Naran and a Bachelor of Commerce. Lucinda Bailey Ewan Nelson and a Bachelor of Arts. Novia Bauer Nig and a Bachelor of Arts. Alexandra Emily Phillips and a Bachelor of Arts. Shanan Satya Pile and a Bachelor of Arts. Sayuri Ram and a Bachelor of Commerce. Natalie Marie Robinson and a Bachelor of Arts. Sophie Rebecca Sheaf and a Bachelor of Arts. Alice Amber Stacey Jacobs and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel James Stanley and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sherry Toe and a Bachelor of Commerce. Irina Hinikura Sherbert Williams and a Bachelor of Commerce. Megan Ruth Williams and a Bachelor of Arts. Yingzi Yu and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours, Emma Frances Armstrong. Michael James Thomas Jack. Timothy James Parker. Taggio William Woodward Price. Lisa Jane Small. Andrew Graham Stewart. Rebecca Louise White. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours Conjoint, Philip James Leneve Arnold and a Bachelor of Arts. Maria Petronella Bialystocki and a Bachelor of Arts. Timothy James Condor and a Bachelor of Science. Christina Kate Zenith Kovic and a Bachelor of Commerce. Claire Elizabeth DeJoux and a Bachelor of Arts. Nicholas William Dobbs and a Bachelor of Arts. Jennifer Olivia Donnelly and a Bachelor of Arts. Zachary William Farger and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel Robert Gapes and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hannah Elizabeth Gillies and a Bachelor of Arts. Callum Toby Hames and a Bachelor of Arts. Kylie Nicole Hudson and a Bachelor of Arts. Benjamin Heath Jackson and a Bachelor of Arts. Daniel Clifford Kelly in a Bachelor of Science. Luke John Leyburn in a Bachelor of Commerce. Megan Lim in a Bachelor of Arts. Marcus Paul Bartlett Linnell in a Bachelor of Arts. David Alexander McCulloch Mann in a Bachelor of Arts. Shane Andrew Misselbrook in a Bachelor of Arts. And Jerry Mitra in a Bachelor of Arts. Shivendra Narayan in a Bachelor of Arts. Shevin Hemdad Nori in a Bachelor of Arts. Susan Jane O'Connor in a Bachelor of Arts. Elizabeth Grace Ogle in a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Law, Sonali Maria Pereira, and a Bachelor of Arts. Scott Julian Petty, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Fiona Margaret Jade Robertson, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Emma Elizabeth Sherritt, and a Bachelor of Science. Ashley Lynn Sinclair and a Bachelor of Science. Julian John Kennedy Spring and a Bachelor of Arts. Igor Tokmadzik and a Bachelor of Arts. Nipur Vipul Upadhyay and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jacob Spoonley and a Bachelor of Arts. Hilary K. Wham and a Bachelor of Commerce. Robert Jeremy Wilson and a Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Singh Tai Yen and a Bachelor of Arts. Rita Hoi Ying Yip and a Bachelor of Arts. Joy Ji Hoon Yoon and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mary Yung Yup Jo and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. To the degree of Master of Laws were first class honours. Rosemary Griffin in Public Law. Charlotte Elizabeth Haig. Sarah Beverly Harrison in Corporate and Commercial Law. Alison Jane Pavlovich in Corporate and Commercial Law. Erin Verko in Corporate and Commercial Law. To the degree of Master of Laws with Second Class Honours, First Division, Rebecca Marie Armstrong in Public Law. Ian Stewart Lawless in Corporate and Commercial Law. Jennifer Puar in Public Law. Nathan Allen Spear in Litigation and Dispute Resolution. To the degree of Master of Laws with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Yung Jun Park. Asilika Agnes Wise in International Law. To the degree of Master of Laws, Rhys Walter Boyd in Corporate and Commercial Law. and in absentia, those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Law.
I now call upon Deputy Vice Chancellor Research, Distinguished Professor Harding, to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Education, Irene Ruth Anderson. Irene developed a tool to help coaches and teachers discuss their beliefs and ideas about teaching and learning during the classroom observation process. When coaches and teachers engage in this level of discussion, teachers are more likely to make deep rather than superficial shifts in their practice. Kimai Toka, University Doctoral Scholar. Kimai examined the possibilities for living as Māori in the modern world. Her analysis of narratives from graduates of the first Kura Kaupapa Māori in Auckland demonstrate the complexities for young Māori who live and practice Māori language and values in a world governed by a set of values and social structures far removed from the traditional world of Māori. The degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Nasser Al-Misfa in Civil Engineering. Nasser investigated the effects of waste paint and crushed glass on the fundamental properties of concrete, with a view to commercialising concrete that utilises these waste resources. Nasser. Nathan William Bailey in Mechanical Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Nathan investigated the dynamic crash impact behaviour of lightweight composite aircraft materials in order to develop improved analysis and design techniques for the optimisation of aircraft structures. Matthew John Paul Barrett in Bioengineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Matthew developed a mathematical model that describes the changes in blood flow and oxygen delivery to brain regions during neural activation. The model can be used to combine data from different sources and improve our understanding of functional neuroimaging techniques. Matthew. David John Brooks in Bioengineering. David developed a computer software abstraction for the exchange of scientific and medical biosignals. His work explores universal methods for data integration to facilitate storage and analysis in a research setting. David. Ravi Avakesh Chandra in Electrical and Electronic Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Reconfigurable computer chips hold great promise for high-performance computing. However, they are notoriously difficult to program effectively. Ravi made major contributions to overcome these difficulties by investigating the use of pre-built data structures and developing compilation tools for scientific applications. Mohsen Shahzad Chaudhry in Civil Engineering. Mohsen investigated some of the fundamental concepts of traffic signal design and operation. He proposed new models based on field experiments to improve capacity, signal timing, and delay estimations at signalized intersections. Subey Jihan Chaudhry in Civil Engineering. Subey investigated the factors which will encourage users of public transport to select routes which involve making transfers. Findings are expected to assist planners and operators in designing and implementing integrated public transport systems. Chandan Datta in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Chandan's research developed programming tools and software platforms that enable real-world usage of personal service robots. The robots help older people self-manage their health in retirement village scenarios. The research developed a domain-specific programming language for representing the robot's behavior and a visual programming environment called RoboStudio to author this. Stuart Ross Andrew Dearness in Education. Stuart scrutinized how teachers responded to the multiple and sometimes contradictory policy demands that shaped their work in schools. He revealed the creative ways they interpreted policy texts and translated these into practices that upheld their commitments to social justice. Daniel John Ducker in Civil Engineering. Dan explored the core requirements for successful participation between managers and communities trying to solve environmental problems to develop the peer framework. He then used the framework to investigate participation during New Zealand's largest environmental cleanup at Mapua. Tennille Jamie Frank in Education. Tennille investigated how to better engage fathers in parenting programs. She used this knowledge to conduct a randomized controlled trial testing the effectiveness of an adapted parenting program for fathers on child and parenting outcomes. Goran Niels Gurdon in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. Goran examined the relationship between gender, the body, space, and pleasure in boys' physical education. He suggests physical education teachers be aware that they are not only enablers of students' experiences of various movement pleasures, but they also shape gendered understandings about these. Stefan Andreas Hassold in Civil Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Stefan investigated how to make public transport more attractive and energy efficient using multiple vehicle types to better match capacity and demand. Rena Edith Heap in Education. Rena's research focused on the teaching of the nature of science, which is central to developing an understanding of scientific literacy. She identified and theorized successful strategies to inform the pedagogical practices of in-service and pre-service teachers. Muhammad Tariq Ali Khan in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. The aim of Tariq's research was to design algorithms that could improve usability of real-time passive stereo sensors. Tariq developed novel algorithms for depth contours generation, points of interest detection, and depth contours refinement. These algorithms can contribute to many applications such as road safety, material handling, sports monitoring, and augmented commentary. Avishek Anand Kumar in Mechanical Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Avishek developed and applied novel control theory to the control of wind turbines, achieving a reduction in the damage on major components of the machines. Bohram Lee in Education. Bohram examined the parenting practices and child-rearing challenges of Korean immigrant mothers and fathers in New Zealand and the behavioural adjustments of their children. Rachel Amanda Felicia Lees Green in Bioengineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Rachel used mathematical models to study how spontaneous bioelectrical activity in the gastrointestinal tract is generated at a cellular level, with the aim of better understanding normal and abnormal gut function. Bo Lee in Civil Engineering. Bo investigated spatial variation effects of earthquake motions on bridge structures, especially on deck unseating and pounding between girders. Aichi Lin in Mechanical Engineering. Anna investigated the knowledge management challenge faced by many New Zealand small and medium-sized enterprises. Based on a 3-year case study, she developed a diagnosis method and companion strategies that will improve the way these enterprises create and store their knowledge assets. Sandika Vamudi Manakara in Civil Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Sandika investigated the core principles required to rebuild communities following natural disasters. She used her findings to create a practical framework to improve post-disaster reconstruction and recovery practices in affected communities. Stephanie Joan Mead in Law. Stephanie analysed the complex legal functions and public governance structures for the delivery of environmental health services within New Zealand, with a view to rationalisation and future reforms. Ian Agnes Milne in Mechanical Engineering. Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar, University Doctoral Scholar. Ian provided new insights into the turbulence properties at tidal energy sites and conducted a series of novel experiments on a model tidal turbine in unsteady flow. The research has assisted in establishing recommended guidelines for tidal turbine testing and is intended to improve the fatigue life of tidal turbine blades. Kenneth King Wee Ong in education. Kenneth found that from a cognitive perspective, Chinese reading texts embedded with code-switched English target words are more effective than graded readers in facilitating second language vocabulary acquisition in English as a foreign language Chinese learners. Code-switched texts can be used as part of a comprehensive English as a second language or English as a foreign language vocabulary intervention program. Marianne Feifei Pale in education. In considering the development of culturally responsive pedagogies, Marianne examined explicit vocabulary instruction to enhance reading comprehension in English of Tongan students in bilingual classrooms. The study demonstrated that with the use of an educational intervention, there were statistically significant gains that were made in the reading achievement of Tongan students. Scott Francis Ray in education, university doctoral scholar. Scott's thesis argues that Dickens, through Hard Times, is a credible source of information for philosophical and historical discussions around education, with special attention being given to the role of education as it is controlled and utilised by the interests of industrial capitalism. Paul Andrew Roberts in bioengineering. Paul refined an MRI-compatible ergometer and imaging methods to assess cardiovascular function during exercise. These methods were applied to a clinical study evaluating the effects of two treatments in patients with aortic disease, which indicated one treatment may preferentially delay the need for surgical intervention. Timothy John Roper in electrical and electronic engineering. Timothy's research made significant contributions to the difficult practical problem of acquiring accurate calibrated hyperspectral images for use in industrial applications. Hyperspectral image processing promises a substantial improvement in machine vision capability, and this work advanced the problem of reliable human skin detection to improve occupational safety in dangerous industrial environments. Jennifer Harjung Tartaby in education, university doctoral scholar. Jennifer's thesis tackles the discomforting yet timely social justice concerns of disadvantage and poverty, which have a direct impact on an estimated 25% of New Zealand children. Her investigation of how New Zealand graduate diploma in teaching secondary pre-service teachers engage with the issues of disadvantage and poverty has immediate implications for the ways in which teachers are prepared to teach an increasingly diverse New Zealand student population. Yu Cheng Tu in electrical and electronic engineering. Yu Cheng explored transparency, a term used in government and business that implied information openness but without a precise definition. She developed an engineering definition of transparency and demonstrated its use in software engineering, particularly for improving communication during the software development process. Shanghai Wei in chemical and materials engineering. Shanghai investigated the effects of alloy and composition and processing technology on the microstructure and mechanical properties of advanced magnesium alloys. His research made significant contributions to the development of a new type of ductile magnesium alloy, which has great potential for applications such as car parts and electronic devices. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record who have qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Education, the Faculty of Engineering, and the Faculty of Law.
We are near the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. Please stand. While you are standing, it would be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. Can you please remain standing? This concludes this meeting of Council and convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme. Thank you.